I'm going to turn it over.
To be back here, as Doug mentioned, U of A won the game last night by 3 points, close contest, another close one here early on. Of course, we're very early, just over 2 minutes in. UBC leading 6-4, working the ball down low to Leah Stansfield. Looks to kick it out, however. It's stolen. Here comes Katie Arbuthnot looking to push the ball for U of A. Nice feed over to Annika Bacher, who's able to lay it in. That ties it up at 6. Good play by the guard Arbuthnot to find Bacher down low. UBC working the screen. Leah St. Pierre looks to pull up, does, but misses. Arbuthnot gets the defensive rebound. She'll push it up once again. Another feed to Bacher, who pulls up from about 10 feet, able to get it to fall. Good start for Bacher. Arbuthnot distributing well here to start things off. 8-6 for the Pandas.
For Bacher, she didn't score.
Drives baseline, eight can't get the lay-in to go. Georgia Popovici steps on the line after getting the rebound, so the Thunderbirds will get the ball back here as they make a couple substitutions. UA also making a substitution as Popovici comes out. In comes Saskia Vanjanovin, who had a good game last night. Little fumble at the top by the Thunderbirds' Chris Young. That's an leading 8-6, 6:50 to go in the first quarter. Jamie Norm, another first-year player for the Pandas, coming into the ball game. She'll do the duties at the point position. Bacher getting it down low, looks to hand off to Marissa Halick, can't handle it. A turnover by the Pandas. Thunderbirds looking to push it. St. Pierre swings it over to Chris Young, the three-pointer. Good. That gives UBC the 9-8 lead. Good look there by St. Pierre on the break. Norm setting up the offense for the Pandas. They'll look to swing it around. Norm getting it on the wing. Looking down low. Gives it up to Bacher. Bacher gets another bucket to go.
Yeah, Bacher, there is a player they're going to look to provide some offense for them. A bit inconsistent offensively throughout the season so far, but a
here come the Pandas. Norm bringing the ball up. Over to the wing. Ball swung around to baskets early on in the ball game. That left-handed hook comes up short. Ball knocked out of bounds. It looks like the Thunderbirds are going to keep it. Maybe even a foul called. Yeah, we got a foul called here. It looks like it was on Huntley.
There's going to be a hold on Huntley. Panda's red hot, 6-for-6 from the field to open this one. That 12-9 lead. And that we saw last night, both teams over 50%. The Panda's at 52%. UBC at just under 54%. So now off to a great start.
A little bit of man-to-man full-court pressure here by the Thunderbirds. Norm bringing it up. Shane on her. Halet turns the ball over. She throws it away. Arian Duchesne. Here by Lassonne as she finds Alex Viewig down low, who gets the easy lay-in, cuts the lead to 1 under 5 minutes. Calling out a play. Marissa Halet at the top, swings it up to the top of the key to Mackendra Asselson. Pandas moving the ball around. Here comes Vanjanovin looking to penetrate. However, the ball's knocked away. It appears to go off Vanjanovin. Thunderbirds getting the ball as the Pandas turn it over.
So the hot start shooting has been good, but that's four turnovers already for Alberta in the first 5 minutes and 22 seconds. So something they're going to have to correct. We saw a little bit of that, especially in the third. Just some of that patience on offense we need to see from Alberta.
Duchesne at the top. Norm plays some good D on her. However, they find Leah Stansfield down low. Ball's knocked away. Van Genoven comes up, but they kicks it out to Norm, who swings it across. Arbuthnot has it. Popovici back in the game. Down low to Van Genoven. Nice move. Spinning to the baseline, able to get the roll plus the foul.
Great job there by Van Genoven. Got the ball pretty deep in the lane, but able to spin, take the contact from Watson, and just spin that one in. UBC, we saw a lot of that 2-3 zone throughout most of the second half last night. They opened at the 2-3 zone. They've gone back to man-to-man here in the last couple minutes after the hot start shooting from Alberta.
Off the free throw, however, Georgia Popovici able to get the offensive rebound, puts it up, gets fouled. So she'll... on UBC. U of A has yet to pick up a foul.
Popovici with a hot night last night, 20 points. Sixth in Canada West in rebounding, 6.7 a game. We saw another one there on the offensive glass, allows her to get back to the free throw line. Where
Popovici makes both free throws, 4 minutes to go here in the first quarter. U of A leading by five. On the wing. Back to Duchesne. Shot clock winding down. 4 seconds to go. Duchesne penetrating. Tough bucket. Able to get it to fall. Up 16-13 for the Pandas. Arbuthnot now playing the point. Over to Norum. Arbuthnot looking down low for Van Genoven. Ball knocked away. A turnover by the Pandas. Here come the Thunderbirds. Pull-up jump shot. Falls for Duchesne as she rattles that one in.
And Duchesne last night in 20 minutes only with 2 points, but there's four quick ones for her as the Thunderbirds back in that zone.
Here's Arbuthnot getting the screen. Working it over to the corner for Kendra Asselson. That comes up short. However, Asselson able to get the rebound. Called for the offensive foul as a Thunderbird is able to take the charge.
It's Alberta's first miss. So they go 7-for-7 to start this one. That 3-point of the first miss. Osselson with the rebound, but a drop step into the middle results in contact the officials felt was enough to warrant the charge.
Erin Duchesne bringing it up. Gives it over to Watson, who looks to kick it out. Ball deflected. Thunderbirds will maintain possession here. 12 seconds to go on the shot clock. 16-15. Pandas lead with 2:45 to go in the first quarter. Substitution for U of A. Alicia Risling will check back in.
Scott Edwards not happy. He didn't think it was tipped, and I tend to agree with him. I didn't think... Yeah, they ruled it was UBC ball.
Duchesne attempting the three-pointer from the corner comes up short. The officials... Katie Arbuthnot playing the point here for... Can't remember who won the opening tip, so not sure who's going to... It looks like the Pandas are going to get the ball back here. Spin move by Popovici down low. Can't get that one to fall. Thunderbirds clear the boards. Here's Alex Fewig. Nice feed down low to Zara Huntley. She kicks it back out to Duchesne. Duchesne over to St. Pierre, covered by Arbuthnot. Good defense there. Duchesne looking to penetrate. Kalick cuts her off. Huntley gets fouled by Popovici down low. Thunderbirds will take it on the side as the shot clock was running down to 5 seconds.
And it's clear the game plan for UBC is get the ball in Zara Huntley's hands. She took 4 shots last night. She was 100%, 4-for-4, 10 points. But you can see early going, they're trying to get that ball into her.
Yeah, she has some nice moves down low and showing that early on, able to get a couple early buckets. Turnover by the Thunderbirds. The Pandas leading by one, under 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Alicia Risling over in the corner to Bacher, who comes up with an air ball from the corner. Here's St. Pierre for the Thunderbirds. Swings it to the top to Huntley. She looks down low, finds Viewig. Can't get that one to fall. Haley with the rebound, gives it up to Arbuthnot. You mentioned they've shot the ball really well when they've put it up, but unfortunately for them, too many turnovers here in the first half or first quarter.
No, you're right. Missed their last three from the field, but again, it's six turnovers right now, and you can't afford to do that against a pretty good UBC team.
St. Pierre, good move as she faked to the middle, went to the baseline, comes up short in the lane, however. Arbuthnot gets the board. She'll look to push. Getting cut off over to Georgia Popovici, who puts her head down, goes to the bucket, gets blocked. Goal, Thunderbirds pushing it up. Huntley getting the feed down low, can't get the lane to go, but it looks like Popovici will pick up another personal second of the game.
And she'll take a seat, Saskia Van Genhoven will check in.
Huntley able to get the first of two free throws to go. Ties it up at 16. 40 seconds left in the first quarter.
Huntley is 70 free throw shooter coming into this one tonight.
She goes 2 for 2 from the free throw line, giving the Thunderbirds the 1 point lead. One man-to-man defense here by the Pandas. Huntley getting it at the top, however, we got a foul off. In a bit of early foul trouble here on a couple of their players. Jamie Norum checks into the ball game for Haylett. Viewick gets the pass. LaSan has been quiet here to start things off. She was red hot from downtown last night. Pull-up jump shot by Chris Young falls. That gives the Thunderbirds the one-point lead. 5 seconds to go here in the first quarter. Arbuthnot asked to hurry. She looks to penetrate. Gets blocked by Viewig. Or by Huntley, excuse me. Good defense there by the Thunderbirds to finish the first quarter as they lead 19-18 here, 10 minutes into the ballgame.
Well, after a pretty hot start shooting for the Pandas, they cool off a little bit. They're 8 for 11 through the first 10 minutes, but it's the 7 turnovers that we saw. And again, in some cases against that zone, it's just poor decision-making. Players not supporting the ball, not helping out teammates, and we're seeing that result in turnovers, and it's allowed UBC, despite the Pandas' hot shooting, to start to stay in this game and right now have that one-point lead.
What do you think they have to do against the zone defense here, Doug, to break it down a bit more, not turn the ball over so much?
Well, we saw a much better job here so far in the first quarter of trying to make that zone move and then look to get that cutback and have Van Genhoven seal the weak side forward. They haven't been able to get that ball in, but again, just you can see the recognition of what they're trying to do, and at least that ball movement is an improvement over what we saw in the third quarter last night, where they were very static offensively,
yeah.
Sort of shooting outside jumpers, and it really allowed UBC to get back in this one. So a much more conscious effort on the part of the Pandas to make it move, get cutters coming through, and find those gaps, especially in the middle of the floor.
Yeah, they appear to be doing some of the right things here in the first quarter, just obviously turning the ball over a bit too much. But like you mentioned, at least they're moving it around and getting some cutters.
We'll take a look at the stats through 10 minutes. So 19-18 Thunderbirds lead. UBC goes 8 for 18. goes 8 for 18, 44% through the first 10 minutes. Alberta, as we said, 8 for 11, 73% in that opening quarter. Rebounding-wise, UBC with 5, Alberta with 8. Alberta, 7 turnovers, UBC with 3. And individually leading the way for UBC is Zara Huntley with 6 points. Rebounding-wise. Only averaging 4 points on the season, but very hot as she goes 4 for 5 in that opening quarter. 8 Arbuthnot with 2 each.
Here we go, starting the second quarter. Thunderbirds leading. Evan Lasson bringing up the ball for UBC. Over to Chris Young. St. Pierre has it at the top, swings it around to Alex Buig. Down low, ball way off on that attempt by Young. Arbuthnot looking to push over to Jamie Norum. She finds Bakker down low. Pandas looking to swing the ball. Nicole Clark making her first appearance of the contest. Arbuthnot covered by St. Pierre. Clark getting it at the top. Gets the screen from Bakker, who pulls up from three. That one rattles out. Van Genoven fighting for the rebound. Good work down low as she forces one of the Thunderbirds to knock it out. Pandas getting the ball back.
Again. So Alberta retains possession.
Norum on the wing. Looks down low for Van Genoven. Good move baseline. Can't get it to fall. Over to Lassong, good three-point shooter. Shoots the three, strong on that attempt. However, Alex Buick gets the offensive rebound for the Thunderbirds. Down. We have a foul here on the Thunderbirds. Alex Buick picking up the person. For UBC. Virginia Watson checking in for the Thunderbirds. On the wing, can't find anybody. And kicks it over to Leah Stansfield, who comes back into the game. Good pass by Stansfield. Was in traffic, and she's able to lay it in, extending the lead to 3 for UBC.
Great job there by Young. Great hands in traffic, and then the presence of mind. The one there by Young.
UBC back in that 2-3 zone defense. Clark getting the kick-out pass. Looks to penetrate. Tries to step across. Clark to avoid the charge. She forces a block on Stansfield, who will pick up the personal foul. Clark should be going to the free throw line here to shoot 2, and she will be.
We'll see what kind of minutes Nicole Clark plays. Again, coming off that foot injury, we know that Scott Edwards wants to ease her back into things a little bit. She did play 20 minutes last night. Obviously had a great night with 18 points. And we'll see again as she starts to get more comfortable and they feel more confident in that foot, we'll see how much time she is getting. Because, again, she is a big asset to this team when she's on the floor.
I think the good news for U of A as well, she appeared to pick it up in the fourth quarter. As the game went along, she didn't slow down. She, if anything, she started playing better.
Yeah, shot the ball extremely well last night, going 6 for 9 from the field, as we said, finishing with 18 points. One thing we should mention on the out-of-town scoreboard, in Canada West football playoff action this afternoon, the Saskatchewan Huskies at home to the Alberta Golden Bears at Griffith Stadium had a 30-3 lead. Logic would suggest that game was over. Final score, Alberta 31, Saskatchewan 30. The Golden Bears scored 28 unanswered, including 21 points in the fourth quarter. And they will now head to Calgary to take on the Calgary Dinos in the Hardy Cup next Saturday afternoon. That'll be Alberta's first appearance in the Hardy Cup since 2005. And a chance to head to the national semifinal, which if the Bears would win, if I'm not mistaken, would be home. So obviously a lot on the line. And the Calgary Dinos, of course, lost in the Vanier Cup last year to Queens, looking to get back. Eric Glavich today and the Dinos defeating the Regina Rams.
Quite amazing considering not too many people were giving U of A much of a chance going into that game, and then being down by 27. Quite a unbelievable comeback by the Golden Bears. Good for them. A free throw there on her second attempt, cutting the lead to one. Looks like Watson will be going to the free throw line to shoot two as the Pandas trail here by one with just under 8 minutes left.
Six on the season from the line, a fifth-year player from Richmond. Previously played with Langara College in Vancouver.
First team foul for the Pandas here in the second quarter. First personal foul as well for Saskia Vanjanovan. Tucker falls on the ground going after it. Looks like we have a jump ball and it's Pandas possession, it appears. Here for U of A. UBC in a zone. It looks like they're still in the 2-3 zone. Thunderbirds able to break it quite easily on this occasion. Lassonde covered by Jamie Norum. Anjanovan will pick up her second personal foul.
That'll be her with, or on the bench rather, with two fouls each. So that's a, we'll see when Scott Edwards decides to bring those three back, if here in the second quarter.
Yeah, and Popovici coming back in. Lassonde, meanwhile, hitting a long two from the baseline, extending UBC's lead by four here in the second quarter. Bakker getting it on the baseline. Three-point land, can't get it to fall. However, Bakker doing some good work down low, getting the offensive rebound, can't make the shot, but it's knocked away by UBC. Pandas will get the ball back with pretty much a new 24-second shot clock, 23 seconds left.
Well, it's been a story of two games already for the Pandas in the sense that they went 7-for-7 and are now 1-for-10 since the midway point of the first quarter.
Here is Young coming up short on her attempt in the key, but we have a foul call off the ball. It goes on a Thunderbird player. I think that was on number 21, Victoria Spang. It was her first personal foul, 13 foul for UBC. Norum on the wing. Pushing it up. Now she'll drive to the hole and gets the lay-in to go. 26-20 here for the UBC Thunderbirds.
Really good quick decision there by Viewing. Saw the lane, just took that pass and went right to
released by Popovici. And Chris Young over to Spangel, who gets partially blocked. 26-22 here in favor of the Thunderbirds. Norum over to Bacher at the free throw line. She'll drive to her right and gets the lane to go. Great first half here for Bacher. She's been keeping the Pandas close.
And that's exactly what you want to see from Bacher. She's got that step. She can get to the hole. She just doesn't. We haven't seen a lot from her doing that so far this year, or even through good parts of last year. So a good job there by Bacher just to recognize she had the lane open and go.
On Popovich, who doesn't want to pick up her third. She may have, as Viewing gets the shot plus the foul. And that one is going on Georgia Popovich, who will pick up her third personal foul here in the first half.
That corner cleared out pretty well there for Viewing, and she was able to go. Clark came with the help. But
I would say for Viewing, Popovich left on a bit of an island there in the corner. 29-24 in favor of UBC, 5-20. Take by Arbuthnot over top of a defender, able to get the little floater there to go, cutting the lead back to 3 points.
Tough play to make when you drive right into the heart of that zone. But like you said, Slav, that little floater kisses it off glass and gets two.
Huntley down low. Good defense there by Arian Sakundayek, who just checked in the ball game. And the Pandas coming right back with a nice fast break bucket, cutting the lead to 1:40 to go in the first half.
Great job there by Ristling. She just pulled away from Devin Lassonde for the easy layup.
St. Pierre getting the feed down low, but she was trapped underneath the basket, had nowhere to go, and 3-second violation called on St. Pierre. Turnover by the Thunderbirds. Pandas getting the ball. Thunderbirds calling a timeout here.
We see Ariane Sekundiak making her first appearance here tonight with the block at the defensive end of the floor, and she's definitely a player that's got that kind of size. She can bring that to the team. Played at the Canada Summer Games with head coach Scott Edwards, first-year player out of Calgary. Special mention, if you're tuning in tonight, able to see the game thanks to Rob Zitlaw and ICU Video providing the footage here tonight at the main gym. Bears and the Thunderbirds coming up later on tonight.
Looks like we're going to have another pretty good crowd on hand here. Great crowd on hand last night. ...29-28 in favor of the UBC Thunderbirds. First half action, 4:33 to go in the second quarter of play. Looks like the Thunderbirds are sticking with that zone defense here. They've been mixing it up a little bit, going to some man. I think at one point I even saw them playing a bit of a...
They have an advantage with that, and again, at times we've seen Alberta be a little bit static. They have done, as we've said earlier, looked more to get the ball inside, whether to Bach or whether to Van Ginhoven. So that's a bit of a change from what we saw last. They kept the ball on the perimeter, and UBC was able to just force tough outside shots from Alberta.
Jump shot by number 12, Alicia Risling, falls. That gives the Pandas the one-point lead. Thunderbirds looking to push the ball up. Viewing tries the turnaround jump shot, can't get it to fall, and we got a personal foul here. Mitchell says that she hooked her defender on the rebound. I don't know if that's an official call, a hook call.
Yeah,
but
that's, I guess, a hold if anything, but yeah, it didn't look like a lot of it there, but nonetheless, they felt enough to warrant the foul.
Evan Lassonde has been fairly quiet here in the first half, able to get that jump shot to go. Back and forth this game goes. Thunderbirds up by one. Risling swings around to Norum, over to Arbuthnot. Asselson over to Norum on the wing. U of A working the ball around here. Sakundayak gets it to go as Pandas go back up by 1:32-31, 3:30 to go in the first half. St. Pierre on the wing. covered by Risling, and the Thunderbirds throw it away.
As that pick and roll, and they had Buick open on the left side of the lane, but she was unable to corral the pass and head in.
Annika Balker checking back in for the Pandas. We got a whistle here. Is it, not sure why they're whistling the ball off here, but anyway, the Pandas have the ball, leading by one. 3:22 left to go here in the first half.
You talked about Devin Lasson, only 4 points so far. She was the star last night, 18 points for UBC, 4-for-7 from beyond the arc.
Good takedown low by Sakandiak, who gets it to fall. She's played quite well here in just a few minutes of play in the first half, coming off the bench. 3-point lead for the Pandas. Leah St. Pierre over to Zara Huntley. On the wing to Duchesne. And we have a loose ball foul. It's going to go on the Thunderbirds.
It's actually a lane violation, 3 in the key.
Yeah, you're right.
On UBC.
Looked like Alex Viewig was parked in there a little too long. Pandas making a little bit of a run here to end the first half, taking a 3-point lead. Jamie Norm driving baseline, pull-up jump shot, gets it to fall. Nice move by the rookie.
And suddenly the Pandas are hot again. Now 15 for 25. So they're 7-for-7, and they're, sorry, 8-for-8 now in their last 8 shots.
Leah St. Pierre getting the screen from Alex Buick, who gets the ball. Pull-up jump shot, rattles out. However, they get the offensive rebound. It's Huntley doing some good work down low. She'll go to the free throw line to shoot 2. Sakundiak picking up the personal foul. That's her first.
Yeah, she got a little bit deep in the lane on that second chance opportunity. Huntley able to just pick the rebound off and go right back over top. And she will head to the line. So far tonight for Huntley from the free throw line, she is 2-for-2, now 3-for-3.
Huntley making the second of 2 free throws, going 2-for-2. 2:23 to go here in the first half. 3-point lead in favor of the University of Alberta Pandas. Huntley feeling some pressure. Her defender off the bounce, loses it, but it comes to Arbuthnot. She's covered by Devin Lasson. Down low to Balker, who's had a good first half. Clark getting it now. Spin move in the lane. Can't get it to fall. Balker, though, getting the loose ball, and then she gets fouled. Looks like the Pandas will get the ball on the baseline. That personal foul going to Leah St. Pierre. Her first team foul, number 4. Arbuthnot getting it at the top, wasting no time, throwing up the 3. That comes up long, but the Pandas able to knock the ball away. Comes to Arbuthnot, who sets things up. She'll drive to the hoop again, and Arbuthnot able to get it to fall. She's had at least 2 or 3 layups, very similar to that one here in the first half.
Yeah, defender gets caught deep in the lane, and good job by Arbuthnot just to go right at the hole. And again, that floating layup.
Then we have a personal foul on Jamie Norm. Looks like, it looked like she got the steal, but the official says no. She Chris Young will do the honors.
Young, first-year player from North Vancouver, made the start tonight. That's her first start of the season. And they're certainly expecting big things out of her. She had a decent night last night, going 3-for-4.
And Young makes both free throws. That makes it a 38-35 ball game in favor of the Pandas. A minute 30 to go. It looks like the Thunderbirds are in a man defense here, and Pandas turn it over as Nicole Clark's pass gets knocked away. Pulling up for 3, but they call it travel. She walked before she shot it.
Much better job by the Pandas here in the second quarter in terms of turnovers. only having committed 8 now after committing 7 in that opening quarter.
Arbuthnot covered by Young. Over to Norum on the wing. To Nicole Clark at the top. Here's Arbuthnot. Looking down, low, bad pass. Taken away easily by Spangel. Here's St. Pierre look to push. Over to Young on the wing. She drives baseline over to Lassonde, wide open. Can't get that one. It goes, it rattles out, and then we have a foul off the rebound. It looks...
That was a really good box out there by Jamie Norum.
Yeah, you're right. It's going to go on Spangel.
She gets pulled to the floor.
That's Victoria Spangel's second personal foul, and the Pandas will go to the free throw line as they're in the bonus now as well. 54 seconds to go here in the first half. They're leading by 3.
Norm heads to the line, 2 for 2 in the season. The Pandas coming into this one, 4th in Canada West. Free throw line, 71%.
That one rattles out for Norm on her first attempt. Jamie Norum going 1 for 2 from the free throw line. 39-35 for the Pandas.
Ms. Kundiak seeing lots of floor time with Popovici in some foul trouble, and it's been a good showing for the young player out of Calgary.
Here's Leah St. Pierre covered closely by Nicole Clark. Uses the screen, gets in the lane, pull-up jump shot rattles in for St. Pierre. Two-point game, 35 seconds left in the first half. Arbuthnot calling out a play. Clark on the wing, covered by St. Pierre. Little bit of a dangerous pass, and it was, as Sakundiak could not handle it. Over and back violation. Thunderbirds have the ball here, 26 seconds to go. They could pretty much kill the clock here. Be about 2 seconds to go if they take it in the last moment. Swinging the ball around. Alex Buick covered by Bacher. Nice crossover there by Buick. Goes to her left hand. Misses the layup. Sakundiak gets the rebound. Here's Norum, will look to push up. Pulls up for 3. That one's off, and that'll end the first half with the U of A Pandas leading the UBC Thunderbirds 39-37.
Pretty good half for both teams. I think you see some of the adjustments that both teams made. We talked about UBC looking to pound the ball inside a little bit more. They did that certainly in the early going. And we've seen the likes of Zara Huntley and Chris Young become key players here so far. And then for Alberta, trying to react a little bit better to that zone. And I think they did do, for the most part, a better job of that, making it move. Again, we talked about the Jekyll and Hyde shooting of the Alberta Pandas. They go 8 for 8 to start. They cool right off, and then they finish going 9 for 11 by my count here. So they shoot 59% in that opening half. So but yet they only have a 2-point lead. So it's one of those things, and the turnover is a bit of an issue for Alberta at various times, and we saw that as UBC went back to man-to-man, a couple poor decisions by Alberta resulting in turnovers the other way, and those turnovers often result in points, and that's why, despite the hot...
Yeah, I suppose it's a bit of a good news, bad news case where you shoot the ball well, which is good news, turn the ball over a bit too much, but...
Take a quick look at the stats through 20 minutes. As we said, Alberta shooting 17 for 29, 59% from the field in that opening half. UBC goes 14 for 33, 42%. Interestingly, though, Alberta goes 0 for 7 from beyond the arc. Last night they were 5 for 3. UBC, the best free throw shooting team in Canada West, goes 8 for 9, 89%. On the glass, pretty even, 6. Zara Huntley with 8. Alex Viewey got a good half as well with 7. For UAlberta, the story. Not with 3. So through 20 minutes, 39-37. Take a quick look at the scoreboard from last night. And one score in from last night, Victoria defeats Manitoba 88-41, blowing out the Bisons in Victoria. Winnipeg in a close one defeats Calgary 60-56. Of course, the Pandas defeating UBC 76-73. Thompson Rivers knocks off Trinity Western 75-59. And Regina last night defeats Lethbridge 70-53. That game tonight already in the books. That matchup, Regina defeats Lethbridge 68-46. Coming up later tonight in Canada West women's action, Victoria at Manitoba. Thompson Rivers again to take on Trinity Western. The Winnipeg Westmen take on the Dinos of Calgary in Winnipeg. And then Saskatchewan will take on Fraser Valley at home in Saskatoon. And of course our matchup here. Coming up after this one tonight, it'll be the UAlberta Golden Bears taking on the UBC Thunderbirds. We'll talk quickly about that one. Of course, UAlberta last night with a disappointing 81-76 loss after having at one point a 14-point lead late in that third quarter. And Slav, what are your thoughts on a game like that? If you look at it on the whole and the context of it, if you're UAlberta, you say, geez, we played the second best team in the country pretty well last night. But when you look at the game itself, when you had that big lead and let it slip, what's the mentality of a team coming into a game tonight?
Yeah, I think they have to look at the positive and think, as you mentioned, that we were close and all nearly beat the second-ranked team in the country, and that certainly should give them some confidence knowing that they can compete and beat the best teams in Canada. However, I think obviously the biggest difference was that 4 or 5 minute stretch in the fourth quarter. I think if they're in the same situation, they can't let that happen, because it appeared that UBC just outworked them during that 4 or 5 minute stretch and wanted it a bit more. Perhaps maybe U of A had the lead and got a little bit comfortable heading into that final quarter, I'm not sure. But I didn't think UBC did anything spectacular during that stretch, but you could tell they really wanted it. Josh White did not play well up to that point, but he started taking it to the hole and pushing the ball up, and the U of A kind of stood around and watched on offense a lot. They weren't moving the ball like they were in the third quarter. I think that's a big thing. When a team goes on a run, you can't just start standing around and looking to take it one-on-one. You got to continue to do what got you to that point.
And I think if there's one thing to look at that game last night, is despite the loss, is that maybe we did see a bit of a glimpse into the future of what this team can become in terms of the UAlberta Golden Bears. We know about Jordan Baker and what he can do. We're starting to see now what a guy like Daniel Ferguson can do. But you also start to see the depth that exists around those two key scorers, and guys like Kenny Otieno, Rob Dewar didn't have a great night, but still a key asset to this team. Todd Bergen-Henningauen had a nice night last night as well. So that's the one positive that maybe we did see. You start to see that team gelling a little bit and starting to see the depth and the versatility that that team has in terms of what each individual player can bring to the table.
I think Rob Dewar did not have a good ball game, obviously, last night, but I think it'll go a long way if he can come in and contribute tonight as well, give him a bit of a low post presence, something that I think they were missing a bit last night. Jordan Baker, obviously a big guy, but you know, a lot of his points come from the perimeter and penetrating as well. So I think if Dewar is able to contribute a little bit more tonight, that can go a long way to helping the Golden Bears split this weekend series with the Thunderbirds.
Take a quick break here momentarily, but first we'll take a really quick look at the standings in Canada West women's action. Right now, Victoria, the Vikes, leading at 5-0. UAlberta and Regina also undefeated. Regina now 4-0 with that win tonight over Lethbridge. UAlberta 3-0. Fraser Valley, Winnipeg each 2-0. Thompson Rivers at 3-2. Saskatchewan at 2-2, Lethbridge and UBC tied at 2-3, Calgary and Trinity Western at 1-4, Calgary may be a bit of a surprise at 1-4. Definitely a team seem to be in the middle of the pack, but one that is expected to contend for a playoff spot. And then Brandon and Manitoba rounding things out, each at 0-4. The top 10 in Canada in women's basketball. The Windsor Lancers at number one. Victoria, the aforementioned 5-0 team, they are number two. Regina, despite the fact they've lost Brittany Reed, a key player in their lineup for the season with a knee injury, so we'll see how that plays out over the course of time. They are ranked number three. The Western Ontario Mustangs come in at number four. The UNB Varsity Reds at five. The Saskatchewan Huskies at six. The Carleton Ravens at seven. The Laval Rougeaux at number eight. The Cape Breton Capers at nine. And the Acadia Axemen round out the top ten at the number 10 spot. Alberta did receive some votes in the top 10 voting, but not enough to get into the top 10. At halftime, it's the Alberta Pandas leading the UBC Thunderbirds 39-37. We're going to take a quick break and be back with second half action. You are listening to Pandas and Golden Bears basketball on www.bears.ualberta.ca.
up here to the top to try to get people for halftime and stuff. So eventually trying to fill 15 minutes gets a little bit much.
We're back here at the U of A Gymnasium. Second half action between the Pandas and UBC Thunderbirds. Pandas leading 39-37 after the first half, looking for the weekend sweep. Katie Arbuthnot driving in the key, misses the turnaround baby hook. Thunderbirds clear the board. The visiting team looking down low for Zara Huntley. That ball knocked out of bounds. It appears it goes off Huntley. That's what the official saw. Pandas get the ball here to start. Over to Marissa Haylett, who had some foul trouble in the first half. Down low to Annika Bacher, who cannot get the lay-in to go. Annika Bacher, nice feed to Marissa Haylett, who did a good job of cutting to the bucket, gets the ball and lays it in.
Yeah, like you said, nice. Haylett able to corral that easy layup for her.
Ball knocked out of bounds. Thunderbirds will get the ball back. 14 seconds to go here on the shot clock. Leah Stansfield swinging it over to Lassonde, down low to St. Pierre, tries the hook, can't get that to go. Georgia Popovici thinking about the three, decides otherwise, then throws it away as Huntley gets the steal. Chris Young nearly loses it for the Thunder. Put some pressure on her. Young bringing it up. Down low to Stansfield, who makes a nice spinning move in the key. Gets it to go. Then a bad turnover by Popovici. And it looks like she may have picked up her fourth personal foul. And she does. Georgia Popovici will have to leave the ball game with her fourth. Was that her third personal foul? Maybe only her third personal foul. Not sure. I thought she had three in the first half. Scoreboard says she has three right now. Either way, Chris Young going to the free throw line to shoot two for the Thunderbirds, making the first of two, giving the UBC Thunderbirds a one-point lead here. 8:06 left to go in the third quarter.
It's one of those things, you make the bad turnover, and then you make it worse by picking up the foul. So
Saskia Vanjanovin coming into the game for the Pandas, in for Popovici. Here's Haylett looking to drive into the key. Nice kick out to Arbuthnot. The three-pointer good for Katie Arbuthnot. 1 point lead here for the Pandas. Devin Lasson over to Chris Young to St. Pierre as the Thunderbirds move the ball around. Young down low to Zara Huntley. Shoots the little 14-footer, gets it to fall. Huntley, very good post player for the Thunderbirds here so far tonight.
Right over top of her. And that's a shot she's going to hit, that little 7-footer.
Arbuthnot looking for Marissa Haley. Good job by Haley to catch that ball. Here's Van Genoven going to the bucket. Left-handed finish for Van. Plus the foul, which is called on Leah Stansfield, it appears. Van Genoven will shoot one.
Again, just you see the strength of her as she is able to deal with the contact, yet still finish so strong with that left hand.
Which is impressive, particularly for a rookie being a first-year player. Strength against some of these girls who are a few years older. Huntley trying one from a little further out, 17 up short, perhaps a bit out of her range. Then Arbuthnot turns it over. She felt some pressure. St. Pierre gets the steal, looks to push to Lasson, who gets fouled by Risling. Lasson will be going to the free throw line.
That's the case there of Arbuthnot, just trying to do a little bit too much, just trying to go around the back, loses control of the ball. And just overhandling the ball. And I think we're going to see Nicole Clark play the point here for a bit. And we know that Coach Edwards is not planning to do that a whole lot this season. But expect to see her bringing up the ball right now with both Arbuthnot and Norm on the bench.
Frisling missing the first of two free throws as her team trails by 166-51 to go in the third quarter. She makes the second of two. Haylett, as her defender was not watching. Haylett takes it to the hole, gets fouled. It looks like Chris Young will pick up the going hard to the hoop, throwing up a wild shot. However, there is a foul called. Free throw line, missing another here in the second half. 1-for-3 right now in the third quarter. Makes the second of two, just like she. Here's Nicole Clark playing the point now. Over to Marissa Haylett. Thinks about the shot, gets trapped. Risling on the wing. Over to Bacher, who's had a good game so far. Comes up well short on that attempt. Gets her own rebound, and he gets a tough shot to fall. Good work by Bacher.
Great job, and she took a ton of contact. I'm not sure how there was no foul call there, but great job by Bacher to follow her shot, get the rebound, and then take the hit and knock the second one down.
Huntley finds herself wide open down low as she drives baseline and lays it in.
Yeah, nice little screen roll there, and UBC able to get the easy layup.
And the Thunderbirds right now looks like they're in a man-to-man defense for the time being. Here's Nicole Clark from downtown. Can't get it to go, but Haylett doing some good work for a guard down low. Gets the rebound. Then she shoots the three. That's short. St. Pierre gets the defensive rebound for the Thunderbirds. She'll push it up. Risling on her. St. Pierre kicks it out to Alex Viewig. Nice cut by Duchesne, who gets the feed and then gets fouled by Marissa Haylett.
That'll be Haylett's third as well.
Yeah, you're right. Haylett picking up her third foul. She will leave the contest, as will Risling. Into the ball game, Kendra Asselson and Jamie Norm for the Pandas. They lead by one here, 5:24 to go in the second half. Duchesne well off on that free throw attempt.
Showing a 69% free throw shooter coming into this one.
UBC not doing themselves any favors here in the third quarter, getting the line quite a bit, not shooting it particularly well.
Which is surprising considering they are the top free throw shooting team in the...
Well, Huntley gets the rebound, tries that little step move, goes up with the left hand, gets it to go. Boy, she's got that to fall a few times here in the Thunderbirds. Jamie Norum feeling some pressure from Lassonde. Arbuthnot at the top of the key, covered by Watts. Jamie Norum, covered by Virginia Watson. Arbuthnot has it now on the wing, looking down low for Kendra Aspen.
Last night, and that's definitely something they want to do. Haven't been able to quite yet, so credit UBC for doing a much better job slowing down the pace of Alberta. Strong on the glass, and then just, again, it's just good fundamentals. Strong on the glass, get those outlets, and then make sure you've got guys filling lanes. And right now, UBC doing a good job knocking shots down, as we see right here with Lassonde.
Great cut there by Lassonde, and a good feed by Duchesne, I believe. Lassonde has been playing well here in the third quarter after not the greatest first half. Certainly wasn't bad. Missed there by Asselson. It off to Arbuthnot. Nicole Clark on the wing. There are 3 minutes and 39 seconds to go. Then the Thunderbirds turn it over as they were looking for a cutting Alex Viewig. Van Genoven checks out. Annika Bakker back in. Here's Arbuthnot over to Bakker in the corner. They swing it around. Down low now to Asselson, who turns the ball over. But it looks like we got a foul called on one of the two Thunderbirds who were covering Asselson. Looks like number 14, Virginia Watson, will pick up the personal foul, her second. And the Pandas are in the bonus here.
Yeah, Asselson looking to kick that ball back outside, and officials felt she was held as she tried to make that pass. She heads to the line, knocks the first one down on the season, 3 for 5.
Kendra Asselson missing the second of two attempts, going 1 for 2 from the free throw line. 53-53 here in the third quarter. Watson fumbling the ball around, able to get it. They swing it around and find a wide open Chris Young on the baseline from 5 feet. She hits the little jumper.
Right,
3 minutes to go.
She was wide open, no one near. And when you got someone that close to the basket, you better have a defender close. And good job there by Young to knock down that little six-footer.
Perhaps a little surprising, the Thunderbirds are sticking with a man-to-man defense here in the third quarter after playing a lot of 2-3 over the last game and a half. Pull-up jump shot by Clark comes up short.
She's been short a little bit, quite a bit tonight, actually, so I'm not sure if that's a foot injury or just not knocking them down.
Virginia Watson looked like she made a nice move going to the bucket, getting the lane, but they call her on a travel before that. So no basket,
Pandas get the ball back off the turnover. 55-53 here in favor of the Thunderbirds. 2:35 to go in the third quarter. Dangerous pass there by Asselson. Gets it over to Alicia Risling, who finds Bacher, then turns it over. Here's Alex Viewig. Ball's knocked away, and it goes off Chris Young. Both teams making dangerous passes here in the last two possessions.
You said it. I mean, coaches will teach you, you don't need to jump to make a pass. And Viewig there, as she cuts in, knew she wasn't going to get to the basket, but that little jump reverse hook pass, I don't even know what you'd call it, something like that, ends up getting tipped away, and the Pandas get the ball back. So a little bit of sloppy play, as you said, Slav, right here for both teams.
More sloppy play as Arbuthnot was looking down low for Bacher. Bad pass, though. So the
there, and you'd know this as a former point guard yourself. You have to wait for that post player to establish position and then let them in some ways determine where it's a little bit, not getting a sense of where Bacher even wanted it.
Yeah, a lot of the times when you're passing down low, for some reason you feel rushed. Really, you shouldn't be. You have to wait for that post player to get good position. If they don't, then don't force it down there. Swing the ball around. Well, the turnovers just continue as the Thunderbirds turn it over on their possession. Here comes Bacher looking to drive. Does, kicks it out to Arbuthnot, but then kicks it back out to Bacher. The long two comes up short. Thunderbirds bringing it up over to Leah St. Pierre. Huntley now, little pump fake, gets around Bacher. Good move, but can't finish the left hand. Then we have a personal foul. It looks like that might go on Vanjanoven.
Yeah, Bacher there just got caught flat-footed as she came out to defend, and that allowed the easy penetration that ultimately leads to St. Pierre heading to the free throw line.
Both teams in the bonus now with a minute 29 left to go in the third quarter. St. Pierre makes the first of two, 3-point lead for the Thunderbirds. St. Pierre rattles in the second. So 4-point lead here for UBC now as number 9, Arian Sakundayak, comes back in for the U of A Pandas. Risling on the wing, swinging it around. The Pandas do. Arbuthnot now on the other side gets it. Had to swing it back the other way. Arbuthnot, pull up jump shot from the baseline, too strong. She had to put that one up with the shot clock.
Good denial there, good post defense by UBC, really limiting Sekundiak and Risling from getting that ball. So good half deny, half front, and it forced UAlberta to keep everything outside.
Here's Aaliyah St. Pierre working on Risling. Top shot by St. Pierre falls. Risling on the wing, swing it over to Norum, who then gives it up to the other side to Arbuthnot. Looks to pass. Shot clock winding down, 5 seconds to go. Here's Norum going to one-on-one. Kicks it out. Risling partially blocked by Huntley. Here come the Thunderbirds, 13 seconds to go in the third quarter. Duchesne calling out a play, 8 seconds. Duchesne looking at the clock. Well, she's taking her time here. Then drives. Gets to the bucket, but it's blocked by Sakundayak. That'll end the third quarter of... leading the U of A Pandas 59-53. The Pandas played pretty well for a while, but the Thunderbirds able to make a run here to end the third quarter and take a six-point lead.
And again, it's another tough third quarter. Last night, they were outscored 26-16 by UBC. Tonight, again, a 6-point or an 8-point swing in that third quarter to give UBC a 6-point lead. So certainly not the kind of quarter. And it was very sloppy both ways. And UAlberta just, again, it's that we talked about it throughout the weekend, that ability for them to play a consistent 40 minutes, especially here at home. That's been a challenge for the Pandas the last couple of seasons. And a tough third quarter. But again, back to that last offensive possession for Alberta. Great post defense by UBC. You can see the Pandas trying to get that ball inside, unable to do it. And right now, we're not seeing them shoot the ball as well from the outside as they did in the first half. And UBC content right now to take those posts away, force Alberta to either try to penetrate from the outside or shoot jump shots. Neither right now working for Alberta.
Credit the coaching staff of the Thunderbirds as well, switching to a man-to-man defense there in the third quarter. It certainly worked out for them as the Pandas were having trouble. Anything you see out there, Doug, that the Pandas could do differently against this man defense?
Well, I think right now it's you got to knock down some shots. You have to force them to respect the outside a little bit more and allow you to open up some things down low. And until you're doing that, they're going to be content to sag deep, take the posts away, and allow you to either try to penetrate through that or shoot. So at this point, the key thing is to start to knock down some shots and get back to that kind of presence they had from the outside in the first half. So that's the biggest thing right now. But and we'll see if they're able to do that. Otherwise, I think you're right. UBC is just going to stay in this man-to-man.
I suppose when a team is able to sag in like the Thunderbirds are doing right now, it makes it a lot harder to penetrate, obviously, and it could cause some more turnovers because the Thunderbirds have a better chance to help out their teammates when they're in tight like that. About to start the final quarter of play here at the U of A Gymnasium, 59-53 in favor of the visiting UBC Thunderbirds, who are looking to bounce back after losing a close one last night to the Pandas. Victoria Spangale in for the Thunderbirds. Gives it up to Chris Young. Over at the top to Arian Duchesne. Swinging it over to Leah St. Pierre, who's covered by Nicole Clark. Down low to Young. Looks to drive baseline. Loses her footing. Gets a little lucky there as Bacher kicks it out. Thunderbirds will keep the ball with 8 seconds to go on the shot clock.
It's been a pretty balanced attack from UBC so far tonight. Lasson, of course, the big scorer last night. A little quieter so far this evening. Zara Huntley's been important, but Duchesne has been scoring from her, too.
Here's Young driving to the key. Good penetration by Chris Young as no help comes from the Pandas. Gets all the way to the hoop and lays it in. A bit of a dangerous time here for the Pandas as this lead starting to extend to 8 points. Kind of seems like the Pandas don't have as much energy as they did last night.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think, again, it is that key time here for this early stretch.
Boy, and they turn the ball over again here. Turnovers have been hurting the Pandas in a big way at the end of the third and to start the fourth quarter.
17 turnovers for Alberta through three quarters, and there's another one. There's number 18.
Here's Chris Young on the wing for the Thunderbirds, covered by Marissa Haylett. Over to Duchesne. Lasson. Nicole Clark all over her. Young gets it, tries a difficult turnaround jump shot. That doesn't fall. Looked like it may have been blocked. The officials think it was just an air ball, so the Pandas will get the ball.
That's a bit of a tough break. I'd say that it's tipped and it's UBC ball, or it's a foul and it's UBC ball.
Yeah.
I don't think that was a pure air ball.
No, it looked like definitely at least got the ball, if not the wrist. 61-53 here, 8:45 left to go on the final quarter of play. Here's Georgia Popovici, who's been fairly quiet in this ball game, gotten some foul trouble early on. She has the ball knocked away. Pandas will get the ball back with 5 seconds to go on the shot clock. Arbuthnot then has the ball tipped away on her inbounds pass, so Pandas will keep the possession. Nicole Clark open from three-point land. That one rattles out. Thunderbirds get the board. Here's Young pushing it up. Huntley at the top, covered by Popovici. Duchesne. Over to Lasson. Good feed to Alex Viewig, who makes the layup. And the Thunderbirds extend their lead to double digits for the first time tonight.
And you feel this one starting to slip away. And I think you're right, Slav, just not a whole lot of energy for the Pandas.
That'll help Marissa Haylett driving to the baseline. No help from UBC. Easy lay-in there for Haylett. Huntley hands it off to Duchesne. Looking down low for Young. Good effort by Haylett to knock it away. Scramble on the floor. Duchesne comes up with it. Shot clock winding down. Ball knocked away. No, it wasn't. It was thrown away. Pandas get the possession.
Yeah, good job by Nicole Clark just to get a hand in the way, and LaSalle just ends up letting that one go flying right out of bounds.
Thunderbirds call a timeout here. Certainly the Pandas could use it, as well as they seem to be a little flat here to start the fourth quarter, trailing by 8 points with 7:42 left to go.
Well, in that third quarter, Alberta shoots 6 for 15, 40%. UBC goes 8 for 14, 50%. Leading scorer for Alberta, it's Annika Bacher with 12. Katie Arbor. She'll be great. The other night, she'll struggle, and we're seeing that a little bit. And again, in fairness, that could definitely be due to that foot injury. Of course, if you're a shooter and you got a and your foot's bugging you, that makes it a little bit tougher, clearly, to make that happen. For UBC, leading the way, it is Zara Huntley with 16, Chris Young with 13. On the glass so far through three quarters, it's pretty even, 26-24 in favor of UBC. We talked about the turnovers, 18 right now for Alberta and 11 for UBC.
Not started the fourth quarter, 7:40 left to go here in the fourth quarter after a timeout. Pandas trailing by 8 points here, 63-55. Here's Risling kicking it out to Katie Arbuthnot, getting the screen. Swings it over to Nicole Clark, looking to go one-on-one against St. Pierre. Drives baseline, good feed to Bacher, who then throws it away. Papavici on the floor. So is Alex Viewing. She comes up with it. Thunderbirds have the ball. LaSalle calling out a play with her team up by 8 points. Clark on LaSalle, playing her pretty tight. Viewing looks to drive to the middle, does, and gets the lane to fall. Papavici could not keep up with her.
It's really a nice finish. Sorry, Slav, a really nice finish there, taking that little bump from Papavici, but able to scoop that one in.
Yep. Here's Nicole Clark on the wing. I'm going to foul off the ball. Looks like it's going to go on the Thunderbirds. It seems like the Thunderbirds have taken advantage of Papavici a few times, whether it's been Alex Viewig or Huntley going on the perimeter and then kind of isolating Papavici a bit and able to penetrate on her.
Yeah, you're right. They've definitely done that a little bit, and that's where you have to rely on your help coming from elsewhere. And in that last case there, again, no help for Papavici at all. She did a pretty good job to stay with the slightly quicker Viewig, but no help in, as we said, the good finish by UBC.
Nicole Clark, bad pass to Van Genoven, who has it stolen by Alex Viewing. Van Genoven does a good job of hustling back and knocking it away, but boy, the Pandas have to take care of the ball, get some good shots up here, trailing by 10 with 6:30 to go as time's beginning to wind down a bit.
Another great play by Van Genoven to knock that ball away and not take a foul. Oftentimes you see players coming from behind, that's exactly what happens, but she did a fantastic job there to get all ball and take away the easy layup.
Bit of a delay here as the officials asking the Thunderbirds to tuck in their jerseys. Leah St. Pierre getting the inbounds feed over to Alex Viewig. Here's Chris Young, turn around. Gets the lay-in to go. Good pump fake there after she spun around. Looked like she was a bit out of control, but able to maintain her footing and get the bucket.
That's a good finish there by Young, but a better defensive possession, I thought, for Alberta. Moving their feet a little bit better, forcing them. That was a pretty difficult shot, but Young does a good job to finish it. And UBC's got their biggest lead of the weekend with 12.
Yeah, things not looking good here for the U of A Pandas. Trailing by 12 now, biggest lead of the ball game for the Thunderbirds. 6:19 left to go. Scott Edwards has called a timeout to try to talk things over and perhaps bring some energy to his team and try to settle them down a bit, especially offensively.
And we'll see what lineup he goes with to finish this one off. because she's had some players at times. His leading scorer, Marissa Halen, has had some foul trouble off and on tonight, so she hasn't been able to get into the flow of things. She's got 6 points right now. And, of course, Bacher has been the biggest offensive producer so far tonight, but she had 8 in the first quarter and 4 since. So, again, the offense has definitely dried up for the Pandas since that hot start.
Yeah, UBC going to that man-to-man defense here in the second half, and it's worked out beautifully for them. As you mentioned, they've slowed down the Pandas' offense, that's for sure, here in the third and fourth quarter. A little bit of full-court pressure now by the Thunderbirds. Man-to-man, it appears. Nicole Clark takes the feed. She's covered by Leah St. Pierre. Not much pressure. Thunderbirds kind of backing up. Here's Arbuthnot at the top of the key, covered by St. Pierre. Spins over to Alicia Risling. Back out to Arbuthnot. Looks for the pull-up jump shot at the free throw line. Gets it to fall.
And that'll help, certainly, if Arbuthnot can keep going. That's 11 for her right now.
10-point lead, 5:45 to go. Here's St. Pierre getting the screen. Looking down low for Leah Stansfield, who has the ball knocked away. Thunderbirds will retain possession with 14 seconds to go on the shot clock.
So a pick and roll. They've run a few times just off the wing. That time a pretty deep entry pass and unable to corral, but UBC retains possession.
Here's St. Pierre getting the screen and able to get it to fall. Boy, not sure if she was even looking at the rim there, but able to get the fall. Obviously, she saw enough. St. Pierre playing well here in the second half in particular. I think she's gotten a few buckets in the lane, driving to the hoop. Extends the lead back to 12. Here's Arbuthnot going to the hole. She gets fouled and will shoot two free throws. Looks like that one was on Leah St. Pierre, and it was her second personal foul. Not a lot of fouls here in the fourth quarter. Looking at it, just two team fouls for UBC, no fouls for the Pandas.
Arbuthnot back to the line. Her first trips to the line so far. Has struggled at the free throw line. 7 for 14, now 7 for 15 on the season. Under 50%.
Makes one of two on that trip. Pandas trailing 59 or 68, 5:10 to go. Here's Risling bringing it up. Arbuthnot on her, over to St. Pierre. Alicia Risling on her. St. Pierre going to the hoop again. Can't get that one to go. Here's Arbuthnot getting the rebound. Looks to push up, something the Pandas might have to start doing a little bit more here. Trying to get some quick buckets. Here's Marissa Halet swinging it across to Arbuthnot. Pull-up jump shot, long. Vanjanoven, good hands to pick it up, but it was stripped away by Chris Young. Thunderbirds get the ball. Alex Viewing over to Lasson. Risling on Lasson. Over to Young. Gets the screen from Stansfield. Here's Young going to the hoop. Good take, gets it to go. Nice little hesitation at the free throw line by Young that takes it in, gets the foul, gets the bucket plus the foul.
We've seen that a lot here in the second half, and it's just right now UBC's just beating Alberta to the basket, and sometimes it becomes a matter of will. And we know UBC's a quick team, but defensively Alberta's proven to be a quick team as well. But right now the Thunderbirds look like the much faster squad.
Yep. 14-point lead now for the Thunderbird, their biggest of the night. Here's Vanjanoven down low. Good spin move to her left hand. Gets it to go. Boy, she's impressive. For a first-year player, she's really good down there.
Just a great fakes the drop step to her left and then comes back, hooks around to her right, and then able to lay it in with her left hand, as we've seen a lot this weekend.
Here's Young getting the screen again from Stansfield. They've been working that pick-and-roll game, you're right, quite a bit here in the second half. Stansfield gets fouled. Not sure if she was in the act or not. She was not. Either way, Thunderbirds will have the ball here on the baseline. 3:49.
She bring UBC back to 500 as they currently sit 2-3. And if the score holds, it'll be Alberta's first loss of the season. They sit 3-0 right now. And
top, good crossover, takes it in traffic, gets blocked, though we got a foul call. Clark will go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Not a lot of contact down there, but enough to get her to the free throw line.
Nicole Clark making the Clark going 2-for-2 from the free throw line. 10-point lead from the Thunderbirds for the Thunderbirds. 3:27 left to go in the game. Felix Fewig, who gets the layup, extending the lead back to 12 for the Thunderbirds. Thunderbirds showing a bit of pressure themselves. Here's Georgia Popovici on the baseline. Tough shot. She'll go to the free throw line, though, as she gets fouled.
Well, the good thing right now is that they're not really closing in too much on this lead, but the points that they're able to get are at the free throw line, so at least the clock's not moving, so that's a positive thing with 3:05 to go.
They're going to have to get stops here, though, with just 3:05 to go. Popovici has had a very quiet night, got in some early foul trouble, and has not been able to pick up her play since. Does make both free throws there. 10-point lead for the Thunderbirds. Zara Huntley has had a good game. She checks back in for UBC. Some pressure now from the Pandas. Chris Young brings it up over half. Picks up her dribble. Over to Huntley. She's covered by Marissa Haylett. Down low to Huntley. Young with the three-pointer gets it to go. 77-64 in favor of the visitors with just over 2:30 to go. Haylett, bad decision there. Try to drive baseline, cut off, forces a bad pass. Lassonde with the steal. She'll work things around here with her team with a very comfortable lead late in the game. Down low to Stansfield on Vanjanovan. She misses. Vanjanovan gets the rebound. Jamie Norum's pass gets knocked away by Chris Young. Panda's not making good decisions down here or down the stretch. Thunderbirds slowing it down as they're in no hurry, leading by 13 points with under 2 minutes to go. The wide open Leah St. Pierre's, the Panda's defense breaking down. 15 or should be a 15-point lead now, it looks like, for the Thunderbirds.
Jamie Norum got caught cheating a little bit high in the lane. And her check, Leah St. Pierre, just snuck in behind her and a great pass inside to her. And she's able to finish as UBC has done extremely well here in the fourth quarter.
Here's Alicia Risling over to Arbuthnot at the top of the key to Jamie Norum for the three. That one went off glass, almost fell in, not quite. Thunderbirds get the board. St. Pierre bringing it up. She'll turn the ball over as Huntley was not looking for the pass. 15-point lead here for the UBC Thunderbirds as it looks like they will win tonight and split the weekend series. A minute 31 left to go in the ball game. Timeout. Well, the Pandas just haven't brought a lot of energy in the second half in particular, I think. Especially down by, you know, near 10 points. With about 5 minutes to go, you'd think they'd try to pick it up a bit. Just haven't been able to for whatever reason.
Yeah, and give credit to UBC. They've done a good job of really eliminating that fast break, eliminating the ability for Alberta to get out. They've beaten them back down the floor. We've seen them do a great job in their half-court defense in terms of limiting the ability to get the ball inside to the likes of Popovici or Vanjanovan or Sekundiak when she's been on the floor. And Alberta hasn't hit shots here in the second half. That's been the simple reality. They haven't knocked down shots, and UBC has. And UBC's had easy shots to hit. I mean, it's been a lot of layups, a lot of deep entry passes, a lot of trips to the free throw line too for UBC. So when you're able to score easily, it makes the game a lot simpler to play. But certainly a tough one for Alberta if the score holds. And again, I mean, obviously playing a good UBC team, but with the struggles Alberta's had at home the last couple of years, they really wanted to get some good momentum built here at home in the early going, and it looks like they're going to walk away with a split.
Ball knocked away by Virginia Watson of the Thunderbirds. However, it comes back to Risling, who swings it over Vanjanov, and Jamie Norm forces one up from behind the arc. Doesn't fall. Ball goes out of bounds. Thunderbirds will get it. 1:21 left to go. Thunderbirds look like they're going to win this one, up by 15. Virginia Watson wide open from the three-point line. Good decision not to shoot that one. No rush now to put it up if you're the Thunderbirds. Alex Viewig down low to Huntley, working on Vanjanovin, who continues to work hard. Ball's missed, a loose ball. Some bodies on the ground. It looks like we have a foul called here. Not sure how you call a foul on somebody and when there's four people laying on the ground holding the ball, but...
Yeah, I know. That's a tough one when everyone's fighting for it, but it's going to be a UBC foul. Alberta will, with UBC in the penalty, Alberta will shoot two. It'll be Vanjanhoven at the line.
Yep, Zara Huntley picking up her third foul. 1:01 left to go here in the ball game.
Huntley as well, she's putting her hands in the air. She's not really sure how that foul is called either, but
yeah.
I think it's really not going to matter a whole lot at this point.
Vanjanovin makes one of two. Risling able to get the rebound over to Bakker, who misses the layup, but she'll get fouled as well and goes back to the free throw line.
It was a tough extra pass there by Alicia Risling. Bakker did a good job to corral that one, spin back around, and get a shot off. Risling actually might have had an easy left-hander herself, but regardless, Bakker at the line. Pandas down 14, so I guess it's not over yet. I probably have seen stranger things happen, but this one would be almost in that miraculous fashion of the Alberta Golden Bears football team coming back today the way they did.
Yeah.
Those of you who didn't hear, Alberta trailing 30-3 against the Saskatchewan Huskies in Saskatoon. Score 28 unanswered. Win the game 31-30, and they will head to Calgary next weekend to take on the Dinos in the Hardy Cup.
Bakker making one of two free throws. Her team trailing by 13. Here's Virginia Watson at the top of the key for the Thunderbirds. Gets cut off. Over to Erica Viewig. Here's Watson pulling up, shooting a wild shot there. A rebound by the Thunderbirds, Victoria Spangel. And she looked like she's... Well, they give the ball to the Pandas. Perhaps Spangel stepped on the line. Not sure what happened there.
Yeah, not sure either, because that clearly went off Bakker. It, like you said, basically went off her face and out. But yeah, they must have ruled that UBC had stepped on the line a couple seconds prior.
Here's Jamie Norm bringing it up for the Pandas. Marissa Haylett from downtown can't get that to fall. Hasn't been a great game for Haylett. This will pretty much do it. 10 seconds left and the Thunderbirds. The UBC Thunderbirds beat the U of A Pandas 79-66 here at the U of A Gymnasium.
No, absolutely not. And when you had a two-point lead at halftime and the eight-point swing in the third quarter, and then UBC was doing anything a lot different. They weren't out on the break a lot trying to change the pace. It was, the pace got really slow, and we've talked about the fact down, and we saw that tonight, and yeah, the energy was noticeably absent in that second half.
That kind of slowed him down a bit, I'm not sure, but
we get the final numbers here shortly that we can run through and sort of verify some of what we've been talking about, but definitely a disappointing finish to a game that looked promising. I thought a good, obviously a really hot start for the Pandas, 8-for-8 shooting to open the game, then they cooled right off.
Yep.
Missing their next seven, but then got hot again, hitting another 8 in a row. So, but then the second half, that just completely disappeared for Scott Edwards and the Pandas. So a difficult one for them, as they will attempt to bounce back. Both the men and the women now will not return home for a couple weeks. The Pandas will head out to Brandon. To Langley to take on the Trinity Western Spartans on the 19th and 20th before they're back for back-to-back home weekends before the exam period and the break hits. And they will be back home on the 26th of November. Grey Cup weekend here in Edmonton as they will take on the Victoria Vikes. And then round out the first half of the season December 3rd and 4th as they will take on the Regina Cougars. We will take a quick break. We'll get those stats and those final numbers to you once we have them. We're going to sign off briefly here and then return. As next up, it is the Alberta Golden Bears taking on the UBC Thunderbirds. The Bears trying to recover from a tough loss last night, a 5-point defeat, 81-76 to the number 2 ranked team in the country. The Alberta Pandas fall here this evening. We will take a quick break and Slav and I will be back shortly. You are listening to Golden Bears and Pandas basketball on www.bears.ualberta.ca.